Hey everyone, what is going on? So we're going to be doing something a little bit different today. Going to take a day off from the Ferocious Cup because I wanted to talk to you guys about something that is coming in 2020, the Go Battle League. Now I know this was revealed the other day, so it's not new information. It's a few days old, maybe even a week old. It was revealed the other day. But I never got around to making a video of it because I already had videos set up of the Ferocious Cup that I had planned on doing. So we're going to go ahead and talk about this, see what it is, see what it means for the channel, and see what we're going to proceed with this when it does come out. So it says, coming 2020 Go Battle League. So, trainers, battling has been a part of the Pokemon universe since the very beginning. We're excited to announce the development of a feature that will build upon trainer battles, the current form of player versus player battle that exists within Pokemon Go. This feature will be called Go Battle League. So basically PvP, which is what we call it, but PvP isn't the official term, but it is They're calling it Go Battle League. Like, you know how they call PvP Go Battle? Well, they're calling this feature Go Battle League. So let's see a little bit about this. So it says, like many Pokemon Go features, Go Battle League will encourage players to get out and explore the world of Pokemon. Trainers will be able to walk to earn entry into the Go Battle League, then battle opponents from around the globe through an online matching system and rise in the ranks of the league. We hope this feature will make the Pokemon Go battling experience more competitive and accessible to more trainers. Go Battle League is slated for release in early 2020. We'll be sharing more details in a special Dev Insights video soon. Stay tuned, trainers. So, first of all, I'm very excited about that Dev video. I can't wait to see more about this feature. So, what is this? What is this, right? It does say early 2020, hopefully January 1st. No, I'm just kidding. It's not going to be January 1st, but probably, I'm thinking maybe in February, but I'm hoping January. I want this to come out as soon as possible. It sounds really, really, really exciting, and I cannot wait for this. It says, in order to battle in the Go Battle League, you have to walk to earn entry into it. So, what does that mean? Well, in the main games, for those that don't know, in some of the games, there's this item called the Verse Seeker. And what the Verse Seeker does is you basically have to walk a certain amount of steps. I think it's 50 or 100 steps. I can't recall. It might be different per game. I don't really remember. And once you reach that amount of steps, then you could activate it, and the nearby trainers who you've already defeated might re-battle you. Some of them will, some of them won't, sometimes none of them will, sometimes all of them will, sometimes half of them, and so on like that. So I think we're going to get a similar feature. I think we're going to be able to walk a certain amount of either steps or kilometers. I'm not really sure how much it's going to be. I think it's going to be more than 50. I think someone said probably about 500 steps to get into the Go Battle League, which is what they're estimating or they're predicting. Honestly, that seems about right. I do have a couple of concerns about this. Like, my only thing is, okay, so once you walk, let's say it is 500 steps or however long it is, how many times do you get to battle in the Go Battle League? Do you get to battle, is it one time for 500 steps, or do you get to battle a set of three for 500 steps? Or is it going to be, and also after you walk the, let's say 500 steps, 100 steps, 200 steps, whatever it is, can you do it again after you battle in these to get 500 more steps and battle again the same day? Or do you have to wait a day? Is it limited? I don't know. Is there a way to bypasses as well if you don't want to walk these steps? Hopefully not. I think a lot of people would be really frustrated if that is the case, if you could battle, or if you could buy, like, battle passes similar to raid passes. I don't know how I would feel about that. I would feel okay because you could use coins, so if it's, like, 100 coins for one battle pass and you get to battle three times, I think that would be okay just because, as I said, if you could use coins, I think it would be reasonable, but we'll have to see. But right now it says it looks like you have to walk in order to get these battle passes. So, that's going to be interesting. I mean, how is the content going to continue, or how is it going to be when this feature comes out? I don't really know, because if you only get one battle for 500 steps, I mean, one online battle per video seems a little bit dull. I mean, I want more battles, you know? So, I don't know if this is going to be an everyday thing. I'm thinking that it probably won't be an everyday thing, although I would like for it to be, But obviously, if we're restricted or limited to the amount of battle leagues we could do per day, obviously it is going to be limited because you can't do more than what they allow. So it's going to be interesting. So those are my concerns. Let me know if you have any concerns with this. But as I said, I hope when we do walk the amount of steps, we could play more than just one battle. It would be nice if, let's say, you walk the 500 steps and you get to battle that entire day, you know, for the rest of the day, if you choose to, or like it's on a 12-hour period that you could battle in, or maybe you have an hour to battle. Who knows? I want to be able to battle longer periods of time, just as I said, to get the content out, and because I want to increase my rank, right? So we're going to be doing that, and when this feature launches, I'm assuming they're going to have Great, Ultra, and Master League. Obviously, our primary focus is going to be on the Great League, but that doesn't mean I won't do any Ultra or Master Leagues. I'll probably definitely be doing Ultra League if they have it. I just need to invest in more Pokemon. But yeah, primary focus will be the Great League, and we'll be using competitive Pokemon, at least in the beginning. You know, I might change things up if this content gets kind of stale, you know, because I know you don't want to see, like, Medicham and Skarmory and Azumarill every single battle, right? So, I might change things up, but it all depends. It all depends how this feature is going to go. So, in the comments down below, I want you to let me know what your concerns are, if you have any, for this particular feature, for the Go Battle League. And are you excited? I'm definitely excited. Once we get the dev video, we'll probably learn more about it. So we might learn how many steps you have to walk, or we might learn how many times you could enter the Go Battle League per day. We might learn more of that. So definitely going to be exciting once we get that video. And as I said, once we get that video, I will be making a follow-up video discussing it and dissecting that dev insight video to see what we have going for us. But I'm really excited for this, and I cannot wait for this feature to be implemented, and I know you guys are excited as well. Now, when it comes to the cups, the monthly cups, I'm not going to stop the Sylph Arena cups. I mean, that content is just going to continue to come, because honestly, I absolutely love the monthly cups and the, you know, the restrictions that they have, the different themes. It's definitely a lot of fun, and I'm definitely not going to stop that. I'm going to continue pushing out daily content for that. You know, I miss a day here and there sometimes, but we're going to be getting the daily content out of the monthly cups. So this is not going to replace that, not by any means. I'm definitely going to continue with that, but this might be restricted compared to those. Like, we might have daily content of the Sylph Arena cups, you know, but we might not be able to get a video out of this, maybe only on a weekly basis. I mean, as I said, it all depends on what kind of system this has and how many Go Battle Leagues we could play per day. But this content is definitely going to keep on coming, and I'm going to be doing a new series called Road to Ranked. So if you don't know what Road to Ranked is, I watched VGC, which stands for the Video Game Championships. People do it. They play online in that series, and they try to increase their world ranking or their global ranking. So I'm going to be doing that with Pokemon Go, and that will be its own series. I might create, like, its own, folder for it, or whatever it's called, I'm off topic, but I might create my own, thing for it. It's own series, you know. I don't know what I'm trying to say. That's what I'm trying to say. Excuse me, guys, I got tongue-tied. But that's what I'm going to be doing when this comes out. But obviously, as I said, once the special Dev Insights video comes out, we'll be dissecting that video. And I'm super excited for this. I can't wait. Hopefully this leads to much better things in terms of Pokemon Go PvP for all of us that really enjoy it. Maybe, you know, we'll have official tournaments that they host, and that would be a lot of fun around the globe. I don't know if Niantic wants to do that, but maybe they will. You know, maybe they will, and maybe we'll have World Championships, Regionals, Nationals. I mean, I know we have that with the Sylph Arena, and that's all great, and I love it. I love every moment of it, but maybe we'll have it fit with the official Pokemon Go and Niantic. So that would be a lot of fun, and I'm definitely looking forward to it. But yeah, so that will do it for this video, guys. And if you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in the next one. And if you have any more information you want about this, or if you want to discuss it, definitely post in the comments down below, and I will see you in the next one. Have a good day. Bye.